Okay, we're gonna take a few minutes to recognize each student. So when I say your name, come on up and you can grab your cord. Parents, this is a good time if you wanna take pictures. Okay. And what the cord is this is something you wear around your neck during graduation. Like so. Mr. Thompson, tell me if I'm doing this right. Okay, thumbs up for Mr. Thompson. So you wear this tomorrow at graduation. If you have other cords, you can just wear all your cords. So, first up, we have Jesus Apodaca. Come on up. All right, Jesus moved here as a ninth grader, and when he moved here, he spoke almost no English. He's worked extremely hard to learn the language and also met all his high school requirements while spending a lot of time working outside of school. And me and Jesus and Ms. Murillo spent many, many, many hours working together on Edgenuity at the end of the year to get him to the finish line.
El primer estudiante que vamos a presentar en la cuerda es Jesús Apodaca. Él se mudó aquí como estudiante de noveno grado, sin casi saber casi nada de inglés. Trabajó muy duro para aprender el idioma y también cumplió todos los requisitos de la escuela preparatoria mientras pasaba mucho tiempo trabajando fuera de la escuela con nosotros, muchas horas. Pasaron muchas horas juntos, Mr. Bartel, yo y él juntos, y para poder terminar los requisitos de graduación, y lo logró. Felicidades.
Okay, next we have Dulce Borjas. Come on up. Dulce moved here as a ninth grader with almost no English from Honduras. She's very social. She learned to speak English rapidly, just as a very outgoing person. And she worked very hard to do well in all her high school classes. I want to share a funny memory about Dulce. I wasn't there for this, but our former EL teacher, his name is Mr. McKinney. Dulce told me this story about one time he offered her a glass of hot chocolate, because he's very nice, gives students beverages a lot. And they were talking, and he said something to make her laugh. And she spit hot chocolate all in Mr. McKinney's face. And I think to this day she still feels embarrassed about it. So I wanted to tell the story while she's in front of everybody.
Esto es Dulce Borjas, se mudó aquí antes, como estudiante de noveno año, y sin saber casi nada de inglés tampoco, es muy sociable y aprendió inglés rápidamente mientras trabajaba duro para tener un buen desempeño en clases de la escuela secundaria. Una memoria es la que platicó el señor Bartel cuando el maestro que ella tenía antes que él le ofreció una taza de hot chocolate. So, caliente. Y ella le dijo algo chistoso, ella le dio risa y le escupió todo el chocolate por toda la cara, lo bañó, lo roció de chocolate. Entonces es una memoria muy que no podemos olvidar nunca. Entonces felicidades por haber completado todos tus requisitos.
It's funny, hopefully you can tell I'm smiling in the picture.
Totally.
All right. Our next student, Jody Chen, come on up. I did not have the opportunity to work with Jody, but she exited the EL program as a ninth grader here at Grants Pass High School. She's had a great academic career here. She's gonna be graduating with a 3.9 GPA. So, congratulations, Jody.
Esta es Jody Chen. Ella salió del programa de EL como estudiante en el noveno grado. ha tenido una gran carrera aquí académica en la Grants Pass High School con un GPA de 3.9. Felicidades. Gracias.
All right, our next student is Jose Eslama. Come on up. Jose has been part of our ESL program here at the high school. He's very social, very funny guy, very talkative at times. He's a little bit of a storyteller once in a while, but this year he has worked extremely hard to meet his graduation requirements. He put in tons of work this year to make sure he got to the finish line. I know that his family is very proud that he is graduating this year. So I also want to apologize for breaking the jack for your apartment. My bad, your tire area.
Este estudiante es José Eslama. Fue parte del programa de ESL aquí en Grants Pass High School. Él era muy sociable, muy divertido y pues contaba muchas historias y platicamos mucho con él y hacía reír a muchas personas. Trabajó muy duro para cumplir sus requisitos de graduación este año y sabemos que su familia están muy orgullosos de él y para que se esté graduando este año. Felicidades.
Okay, next up we have Alberto Montejo Malala. Come on up. Alberto exited our ESL program as an 11th grader, but he still spends a lot of time hanging out in our room. He's grown a lot as a student and a young man since I've known him. He has a little bit of a rebellious side, and he isn't afraid to question things that he is curious about. He's very artistic, and to this day, many of his drawings still decorate my classroom. So it's been a pleasure to know this young man.
Este es Alberto Montejo Matala. Salió como estudiante del grado 11 aquí con nosotros en el programa. Ha crecido mucho como estudiante y joven desde que lo conocemos. Tiene un lado a veces rebelde, pero tiene también muchas preguntas sobre cosas. Es artístico y sus dibujos ahora decoran el salón de Mr. Bartel. Felicidades.
Okay, next we have Miriam Morales. Come on up. All right, Miriam exited the ELL program as a fourth grader at Lincoln back when Miss Diego was down at Lincoln. She showed perseverance to finish all her requirements to graduate this year while she juggled school and also a job to get to the finish line. She's an older sibling, and I know she's setting a great example for her younger siblings here today, and I know that her family is very proud of her for graduating.
Este estudiante es Miriam Morales, salió del programa de EL como estudiante de su cuarto grado en Lincoln. Mostró perseverancia para cumplir sus requisitos y también terminando todos sus trabajos aquí en la escuela. Y como siendo ella la mayor de su familia, la hermana mayor, dando un gran ejemplo a sus hermanos menores al ser la primera de su familia en graduarse, haciendo a la familia muy orgullosa. Felicidades.
Okay, next up we have Kevin Orozco. Kevin moved here as a 10th grader. When he moved here, he spoke almost no English, but he's worked extremely hard to improve his English. He's loyal to his family. He He always puts in hard work, no matter what he's doing, whether it's school, working at a job, or whatever he's doing. My favorite memory of Kevin is last year we were doing some kind of, I don't remember, some kind of exercise. It was like a punishment for losing a game. Some kind of exercise, and Kevin was doing some kind of dance move or exercise, and he ripped his pants open, his whole leg out of his pants, and I don't know, I think he went to his last class with almost half naked, so congratulations, Kevin.
Este es Kevin Orozco. Él se mudó aquí como un estudiante de décimo grado sin hablar casi nada de inglés o ¿hablabas un poquito de inglés? Sin hablar nada de inglés. Este es extremadamente trabajador, es leal a su familia, siempre trabaja duro sin importar lo que esté haciendo, le echa ganas. La memoria que contó el señor Bartel fue que estaban haciendo algún tipo de ejercicio o movimiento de baile en la clase y que se le rompió el pantalón. Entonces este, dice que es algo inolvidable. Muchas felicidades.
Okay, next up we have Tatiana Ross. Come on down. Tatiana exited the EL program in fourth grade at Lincoln, so I haven't gotten the opportunity really to know Tatiana, but I do know that she has juggled school and work this year, and she's also a superstar athlete, and I was talking to her before, I know that she's a sprinter, she does all the fast races, so congratulations on juggling all these amazing things that you're doing.
Esta estudiante es Tatiana Ross, salió del programa de EL como estudiante en el cuarto grado de Lincoln y este año hizo mucho trabajo y como es atleta también, trabajó muy duro para eso y es una atleta muy buena. Felicidades.
Okay, next up we have Arjun Sharma. Come on down. All right, Arjun as well exited as a sixth grader at North, so I haven't gotten to know him too well. I do know that he works very hard, and he also works, and he still found time to work and meet all his graduation requirements. I do have a memory of him, his younger cousin, right, Dave, okay? Was a student here last year, and you know, the first memory I have of Arjun is coming to check up on his family member. And to me, that tells me a lot about what kind of person he is. He's a stand-up guy, loyal to his family. So congratulations on making it.
Este estudiante se llama Arjun Sharma, salió como estudiante del sexto grado de EL en North Middle School. Trabaja muy duro, es muy trabajador. Trabaja todo el tiempo y aunque también trabajó muy duro para completar todos los requisitos para la graduación. Una memoria que contó el señor Bartel es que él tenía un primo que estaba en la clase del señor Bartel y que él venía a chequear y a ver cómo estaba haciendo o qué estaba haciendo, si necesitaba ayuda o si estaba bien. Entonces dice el señor Bartel que eso muestra qué tipo de persona es. Que pues, se preocupa por su familia y que le gusta ayudar y este, es muy leal a su familia. Felicidades.
Okay, next up we have Garima Sharma, come on up. All right, much like her brother, she exited our program as a sixth grader at North, so I haven't gotten to know her very well either. She also came in to check up on her cousin. He was a student here, so again, that shows a lot about what kind of person she is. She's graduating here after having a great academic career. Her final GPA is, I believe, around 3.7, so her hard work is evident. So congratulations.
Esta estudiante se llama Garima Sharma. Salió como estudiante de sexto grado en North Middle School. Ha tenido una gran carrera aquí académica en la escuela con nosotros, enseñando que su GPA es el 3.7 y enseña, pues es evidente lo que ha aprendido y que hace un buen trabajo. Felicidades.
And then, is Pamela here? Maybe not. Is Dominic's not here either? Is Alejandro?
Alejandro, no, but his mom's here.
Oh, Alejandro's mom is here, okay. So Alejandro, even though he's not here, you can have...
No, I'll give it to you.
So Alejandro, he exited as a third grader at Redwood, and he's a compassionate, nice young man. I haven't spent that much time with him. But he persevered also at the end of his senior year to make sure he got to the finish line, so his hard work is evident.
El estudiante Alejandro Mendoza no está presente hoy aquí. Aquí está su mamá para recibir su cuerda. Salió como estudiante de tercer grado en Redwood. Es una persona muy, es simpático, respetuoso y es un joven, un muy buen estudiante y joven todo alrededor. Y trabajó muy duro para conseguir también, para conseguir los requisitos que necesitaba para graduarse. Felicidades.
And then we had a few students who couldn't make it, but I just want to mention them. So if you know these students and want to just give them a congrats. Daniel Salazar couldn't be here today. Pamela Valdez Castaneda. Dominic Vargas, and also Alejandro. So, special thank you to Las Palmas for providing food for the event. We also have some cake that we're going to be serving.